everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The children of the corn have invaded Lincoln. It is a sea of red, an always sold-out Memorial Stadium, one of the most intimidating venues in all of college football, and Nebraska set to defend its home turf. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brett Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
In Nebraska.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Toledo lines up to kick this one off, and we're just about set to get underway. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 32. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He scrambles. He's to the 40. They'll bring him down at about the 49.
This is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49. That's a great tackle at the 47. 2 yard loss for the halfback.
Second and 12. Tight end right. Four down. Mike 56. Set.
Right. He's at the 40. And down he goes.
At about the 33-yard line.
From the 33-yard line, first down. Very good tackle in space. From the 15-yard line, it's first down.
Mike 56.
Sets up a screen, tailback's got it, and they push him out at the 8-yard line. Nothing going there.
No gain on the play. That makes it third and three.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Mike 56.
He's taken down at the 8.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker, and he got through almost untouched.
Nebraska is looking to go up by 3. Kicks away, and it's good. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
Let's check in on some Big 12 action. And for SMU, they've now dumped four in a row.
All right, thanks, Reese. Lewis is lined up to kick this one off. He'll return it from the four-yard line. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line. The Rockets have got a guy at quarterback that is a true leader. We found that out this week talking to him.
We sure did, Brad. It was interesting this week, and as you and I prepared for this game, finding out that he called a players-only meeting without any of the coaches just to get this team focused and let them understand what it takes to go on the road and to win this kind of game. And when you have that kind of leadership, you got a real chance to be able to go on the road and win.
And he's tackled right away. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Here's the halfback. Makes it out to about the 49. He's tackled at the 34-yard line.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz coming.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34. Nice run up the middle. Banks comes away with 5 yards on the carry.
That brings him second and five.
They got to him before he could get back to the line. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed him.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 24. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Well, they dug a bit of a hole for themselves and were forced into a low percentage pass play here on third down. But the good news is they still have a shot at some points.
This one will go into the end zone and they'll bring it out to the 20. A good job on their last drive, getting 3. Let's see if they can get some more on this drive. Nebraska is up a field goal. And he hits him hard at the 29. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Scrambling around. He's to the 40. There's a very impressive open field tackle. From their own 48-yard line, first down. Tackles him hard at the 39-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Stewart takes it right side. Breaks one. Tackle around the 31-yard line. A tight, low-scoring game in that first 15 minutes. Let's see if things open up in the second quarter. 3-0, Cornhusker.
to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point.
Mike 56, Mike 56. Down, blue 14.
And he's tackled at the 19. From the 19-yard line, first down. Nebraska holds a field goal lead. The 10. Touchdown, Nebraska. And he converts the extra point. A nice six-play, 80-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
Lewis ready to kick. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
It's the tailback, and he's level at the 36.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long-range yards.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
And he is drilled at the 49-yard line.
That makes it 1st and 10.
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line.
Let's go, let's go.
He gets out to about the 48-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Down right around the 30. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
From the 30-yard line, it's 1st down. Fires it out. He's pushed out of bounds around the 14-yard line.
16 yards.
From the 14-yard line, 1st down. Goal after a decent pickup.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings him 2nd and 5.
Here's the 8th play of the series. And he's taken down just outside the goal line.
Gain of 9 on the play. That makes it 1st and 10.
It's 1st down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Hold this.
They'll get him in the backfield. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
Let's go, let's go.
offense. Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. He splits the uprights with the extra point.
A 10-play, 74-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
He's out to the 30, and he makes it out to about the 34-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Nebraska has a three-point lead. Once and all, going deep.
That was really a remarkable catch. The quarterback didn't throw a good ball, but the receiver made a great play.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down.
As an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
We've got third and 10. Ball on the 21. Quick strike to the back, and he drops it. He gets it up, and it is good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Throws complete, and he stopped immediately. Smith gained 7 yards with a catch there. Toledo's going to take their first time out of the half. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Let's go, let's go. We've got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up.
Brad, this is a good job by this defense of getting after the quarterback, and until this offense finds a way to slow down that pressure, if I'm the defensive coordinator, I continue to dial up the blitz.
Corner. He might have a chance down the sideline, and they make the stop at the 20.
What a huge third down run, a big gain, and a new set of downs to keep the drive alive.
So it's first and 10 after the big run. Tackle made at the 9-yard line. He scrambled. The 10. He has some room. They'll bring him down
around the 4-yard line.
He's going left.
Fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. It's up, and the field goal is good. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Let's take a look at some action in the Big 12. The Longhorns have the lead, 28-20.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. Toledo to kick.
Kid back to return.
Kid fields it at the 11. Tackle made at the 34.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Nebraska is up by three.
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. And down he goes at the 31. They lose 3 yards there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
It's second and 13. Ball on the 31. Wants to go long and does. He's tackled
at about the 25-yard line.
Man, that was an impressive-looking play. When you can slice apart a defense like that, it puts a seed of doubt in their minds.
It has the distance, and he splits the uprights. And he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
16-10, Nebraska. Excellent kick. The return team looks ready to go. They need to take this one all the way in order to lead at the half.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to lose possessions.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Cornhuskers in front by six.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. One of the unintended consequences of this game, if Herb Street and Nessler have a flight to catch, they ought to be able to get there on time. This thing's flying by because both teams are running the football. That's minimizing the number of possessions in this game because the run games have been so dominant.
Yeah, you just run, you eat the clock. A lot of times you wear out other defenses too. If you hold the ball for long stretches of time, you see the second unit start to come in. So these are huge body blows that pays dividends later in ball games. If you can run the football effectively, now listen, you want to sprinkle in the play action, but the running game's definitely making this game go fast. Incompletion, stop the clock. If we're not throwing many of them, don't worry about it. Just going to run the football the whole time.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm looking at something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 24.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He's taken down.
Right around the 24-yard line.
The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
Well, those are the kind of hits that'll take some miles off a ball carrier.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. They tackle him there, and he's still going to be short.
I think the play call was the right one by the offense. I just think the defense made a better play. They seem to want it more here on this big third down. Offense comes up a little bit short to set up a fourth down, but give all the credit to the personnel on the defensive side of the ball.
Sheds that one. He's to the 40. He's tackled at the 44.
They're ready to begin another drive.
Nebraska with a 6-point lead. Gets to about the 44-yard line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 44.
Down of bounds at the 43-yard line. Halfback's got it on the quick throw, and they get him in the backfield for a loss.
That brings up second and 13.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 45.
Mike 56. Set. Texas. Muscle.
He's scrambling. Tackle
around the 38-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
Mike 56. Down. Check, check. H. Bruin.
Motion.
And he's tackled around the 24-yard line. Nebraska is up by 6. Inside the 10. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. The extra point. Let's throw out to Reese now for a studio update.
Three words say it all. Red River rivalry. Oklahoma and Texas. This one's been entertaining us all day long. One word to describe this rivalry. Nasty. Texas on top, 38-34.
All right, thanks, Reese. Lewis has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Houston from the 2. Tackle at the 21-yard line. Nebraska is the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Down at the 36-yard line.
Gain of 15 yards.
First down. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36. He's got it out to his tight end. He's knocked out of bounds at the 49.
You know, having a playmaker at tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. He's taken down at the 50. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Down and they need to get it down to the 39. They come out in a five wide set. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
That would have been a great play if the throw were just a little bit more on target.
At the 14. He's taken down at the 47. That's three down and one to go. Nebraska's got a 13-point lead. Here again in the fourth quarter. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gaining 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 43. He gets to about the 34-yard line. He fights forward to about the 33. Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 33. Another run, and he's going to be brought down in the backfield. And he was pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what? That was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
To the end zone. The receiver found a hole in the zone and turned it into a first down.
No matter what type of defensive coverage you have, there are always going to be holes. The best thing you can do is make those holes small so the quarterback can't get the ball in there.
They're crowding the line. Touchdown, Cornhuskers.
Great job of finding the space to run and just bursting in for six.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. A six-play, 46-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. Lewis gets set to kick this one away. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Five wide.
Let's go, let's go.
There's a strike complete. And they make the stop at the 46.
Martin makes the tackle at the 46-yard line. First down.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation.
Quick strike and he drops it. So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 46. Gets it out quickly. Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 36-yard line. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Scrambling around. And they got him. That's the second time that he sacked their quarterback today.
This offensive line, it must feel like they're going up against an avalanche on almost every play. This guy's putting up some really good pressure on him.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Quickly to the tight end. Tackle made at the 34-yard line. This offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Hey, Oklahoma!
Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
Game of 7 yards. That brings in second and goal.
Roger, Roger! Mike 56!
Just under 2 to go in the game.
All day, just like that.
Set,
just like
Oklahoma.
That.
Oklahoma!
Bring him down behind the line.
The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for him.
That makes it third and goal.
Let's see how the quarterback handles this one. It's third and goal from the 7. Touchdown. Converts the extra point. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Three words say it all. Red River rivalry. Two longtime powers meet, Oklahoma and Texas. Rivalry is the lifeblood of the sport, and cutting the other guy's guts out is very satisfying. The Longhorns take it by 11.
And for Nebraska, they met up with the Sooners last week.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He gets out to about the 15-yard line.
Well, late in the fourth quarter, this game has been over for a long time, and now we just want to get out of here like these two teams do.
He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 15-yard line. Oh, and almost picked off.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken up, but getting the turnover would have been really big.
Quarter, but this game's been over almost since the beginning. But I think it's time for everybody to head to the locker room. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick.
Didn't get all of that one.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Nebraska up by a big margin.
And down he goes at the 33-yard line. Stewart gets 3 yards on the play. That'll make it second and seven.
A fun week for one team, a nightmare for the other. It's final.
Nebraska, 37, Toledo, 10.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.